When the time comes to take the exam will appear at the top of the My Open Math page above the calendar. There will actually be two parts. One is the exam itself, and the other is a place where you can submit additional work. The only things you're allowed to use on the exam are blank pieces of scrap paper and a scientific calculator. You may not use your notes, you may not use the text, you may not use a graphing calculator, a cell phone, any internet resources, any outside person, or any other resources. When you're ready to begin, click on the exam. And again, another reminder of what you're allowed to use on the exam. Now, the exam is timed like the quizzes, and like the quizzes, the timer does not pause for any reason. So make sure you have enough time to take the exam. Once you're ready, start the assessment. Another reminder that the timer does not stop for any reason. So if you're really ready to begin, start the assessment. So you'll see a bunch of suggestions for how to show your work if you want to enter your work on the exam itself. Your instructor will probably give you some additional details of how they want to see your work presented. The first question on the exam is an honor pledge. This essentially says that you'll take the exam in the way that you're supposed to take the exam, without outside resources and so on. In particular, you're not going to use outside resources, you're not going to use non-permitted technology, and all the work is your own, that you haven't given or received help from anyone. And if you are willing to make this declaration, type in your full name in the answer box. And importantly, every time you finish an answer, click the Check Answer button. Now, on the quizzes, this will actually give you a score, but since many of these questions have to be graded by hand, the score is not going to be relevant. Ignore the score. If you scroll down, you see that the questions will be very similar to those on the quizzes with a slightly different format. So, just like on the quizzes and the homework, there will be an answer box where you can enter in your answer. But there's also a space below the answer box where you can show your work. And in this space, you can type in the work that you would do to solve the problem. It's very important to keep in mind that only a small portion of your grade is going to be assigned for the right answer. Most of the grade is going to be based on the work that you show, so it's very important to show your work. You must show your work to get full credit for an answer. And it's your choice whether you want to do the work on a piece of scrap paper and then transfer it into the answer box, or you could just type your work in the answer box itself. And, just like the assignments and quizzes you've been doing all semester, your answer should be typed into the answer box. And just like on the assignments and quizzes you've been doing all semester, every time you complete an answer, check Answer to submit your work. And again, ignore the score. In particular, the only part that's going to be graded automatically is what's in the answer box. Your work is going to have to be graded separately. So, ignore the score. So again, type in the answer to the questions just like you've been doing for all of the assignments and all of the quizzes to date. In the answer box below, show the work. And don't worry too much about the formatting. Write down the relevant computations that you made. And always check Answer. Once you've answered all the questions, submit the assessment. It will ask if you're sure you want to submit the assessment. And again, ignore the score. Now, the best thing for you to do is to type up your work in the answer boxes provided for showing your work. But if you don't want to do that, you can also do your work on a piece of scrap paper and scan or photograph it and upload the images. To do that, after you've completed your exam, click on where it says Exam Additional Answers, and this will give you the opportunity to upload some additional work. So start the assessment, and the section will allow you to upload additional pages of work. After you've scanned or photographed your work, choose File, and Upload. And once you've uploaded all your files, submit assessment, confirm that you're ready, and again, ignore the score.